Joining me to take a further look at this issue is Mr. Ezenwa Wagu, a civil society activist. Good to have you join us on the News at 10. Quickly, going through all of those guidelines, what hits you the most?
Well, the most offensive really will be the one that, in my view, purports to censor the media. In such a manner that, though it's not just unique to judicial, the NJC, public institutions in Nigeria have made it a policy to continue to defend the Secret Act. Recently, if you remember, Suleiman, you recall that you were told that journalists will have to take passes to get to places of insurgency in the northeast, and the rest of them get clearance and all of those kind of things. So I think the agency is borrowing from that. But it offends public sensibilities for an institution that has come heavy under attack of having integrity deficits to continue to think that it can be opaque, it will not open up its processes for public scrutiny. If it continues that way, then you would really attract more attention, because once a system is opaque, then it behoves on the media to shine much more light in that area than ordinary. So I think that that particular section is shooting itself on the foot and will make Nigerians become more interested in what the NJC is doing.
You know, now the NJC, the spotlight is on the NJC all of a sudden, and for so many, they say this is not the first time petitions or complaints have been written to the NJC. Would you say that the action of the DSS or SSS, as some lawyers would want to call them now, have actually spurred the NJC into action?
It's not just the NJC. I think anybody that has something to do with judiciary in Nigeria, there's a consensus that there needs to be some sort of reforms within the judiciary. What the problem has been the way and manner the DSS carried out. That is what the contention has been. I think across board, both lawyers, litigants, and even the judges, some respected judges themselves, agree that there is need to shake up not just NJC, but even the Nigerian Bar Association needs to take a little more interest in what happens within its fold. So I think that the action of the SSS spurred not just shook everybody up to come to terms with what we already know. What we already have, there is a lot of advocacy in that direction, saying, look, not just the judges, but even the whole paraphernalia of justice system in Nigeria needs a shake-up. And that's what the DSS has been able to...
And we'll say that the shake-up is already on. But if we need to have the judiciary, which is a very critical arm of government, what do you expect us to be doing at this point in time, knowing full well that even now the media seem to have been barred from peeking, you know, having a peek into what is happening there?
No, I don't think the media has been bad. I think what has been bad is public relations. Those who do public relations for NJC will have nothing to do. But the media, those who are journalists, who know that their work is also to report what NJC doesn't want them to report, will do their work. But beyond that, I think that civil society, the media, and concerned Nigerians have to take particular interest in that section, in that very arm of government. It is, as we say, the one that is closest, the one that is said to protect the common man. Once it is imperiled in any way, then it behoves on all of us as society to show more interest, to help them. We need to assist them also to do their work better. And one of the ways to do that is to ensure that there is a whole lot of whistleblowing within that system. And so any program, any policy, any codicil that is brought out to ensure that there is no whistleblowing is going to fail. And I think there are young lawyers right now who are interested in saving their profession from disappearing, because if the judiciary continues the way it's going, the respect, the privileged position it enjoys in society will be such that if you just see any lawyer, you just see that lawyer, and that is not what a lot of them want.
I think that's a fine place to anchor it. Ezinwa Wagwu, a civil rights activist, many thanks for speaking with us on the News at 10.